we do is we understand normal development. And so if we have a mobility impairment, we always want to try to negate the problems that come with immobility. So if you're not moving, you're not exploring. If you're not exploring, you're not learning. And so we always say that you learn to move, and then you move to learn. When you have kids with mobility impairments, you take away from their experiences in regards to development. And so if we can put a tool in place to help them be mobile, they start to receive the benefits of overall development. And we're trying to keep them on the curve as much as we can in regards to typical development. And that's what these tools are used for.
When you have a normal, healthy child, like it's hard to kind of keep in mind that all of their developmental and everything that they experience like leads to further on down the road how much they grow. And it was awesome to be able to get something that we could get her up and moving and mobile, even though she wasn't crawling, so that she could explore the house.
We want to give them the opportunity to move so that they can have some self-determination, participate with their family members, and just explore a little bit on their own to facilitate their development.
So this was a project in partnership with Shriners Children's Hospital. One of their engineering guys was working on a mobility device for infants between like ages 9 months to 14 months. So they wanted us to kind of look at their design, refine it, and then try to make it like publishable.
So what we've been able to do in here at Shriners, we've always want families just to have access to these tools. Sometimes we're limited on our resources, and so we found a beautiful partnership with UATP in allowing us to move forward and have expectations on us to keep moving forward. And personally, that motivated me to keep moving forward. And I think this goal is very possible now for the state of Utah to have access to on-time mobility. And we're doing something. We're doing our part to provide that to families in a great partnership. And there's other people that are involved in this partnership as well. But UATP and Shriners Children's have allowed this to blossom. And I think it has a bright future.